Hey, what's up, everyone? Morning. Just gonna make a chicken tikka masala with in a BIR style, like the restaurants would, with the chicken tikka that I marinated with East at Home's chicken tikka marinade last night, and using East at Home products. So, just a quick show. I'm using East at Home coconut milk powder, East at Home almond powder, obviously just normal sugar, and East at Home chicken tikka masala paste with East at Home base gravy, which is warm, ready to cook with. I've just turned it off. We got coconut milk and single cream. The only difference from the recipe they give is I'm gonna be adding a quarter of a teaspoon of Kashmiri chili powder and about a teaspoon of kasuri methi, because I like that. And I've seen a few recipes that use this, and a little shake of garam masala as well. Always got my butter ghee ready to go. Covered my cooker a bit to try and stop the splatters, but obviously it's going to get everywhere with this setup. I haven't cooked on this stove or on the cooker before, so got my aluminium pan and my chef spoon ready to go. So let's set the camera up and crack on with it. Right there, let's turn this on. Get the pan warm. Get my ghee in melted now, so we're going to get down to a medium heat. Put the pan on lightly and hopefully it doesn't drown out the sound. So, I'm gonna add my coconut powder, almond powder, and the sugar. Try it off for a couple of minutes, 30 seconds or so. Awesome. It's a masala paste. Thank you. turn this down a bit. Don't want it to burn. That's three or four chef spoons of the base gravy. Add some chicken teeth that I prepared. Coat that now in the masala. Get this well coated. Had half of what's left. And the base gravy. Get the heat up a little bit on that. With an initial mix. Right. Just let that simmer for a few minutes. Just stir it in occasionally now. Anything on the side, just cook, stir it in. more gravy. I've already pre-cooked my rice, so just warm that up a minute in the microwave. Right now I'm just gonna add my chili, Kashmiri chili to the outside. Let that cook in. Take away the rawness a little bit. This isn't part of the normal recipe that I'm following, but I'm just tweaking it a little bit to make it my own, how I like the meal. The rice ready. Just normal basmati rice with tejpata, Indian bay leaf in it when I made it. Just put that one side now. Right. Start the rest of the base gravy. It's a little bit hard to get into the pan with it being so high off the ground, so I'm obviously another 6 inches higher. So just stirring in from the edges as it cooks. It creates more flavour. The heat down a bit lower on that now. Check the camera, yep. Right, quickly, I'm just gonna rub in a little bit of kasuri methi. Dried fenugreek leaves. Bit of extra flavour because these tikkas can be quite bland sometimes and sometimes real sweet, so just offset that and give it a little bit of an umami flavour, I suppose. Simmer a minute. I'm just going to add a little touch of garam masala, just a sprinkle. I'm going to add about a chef's spoon of coconut cream from a tin. Bring it back up to higher minute. Normally that might have gone in a little bit earlier, but I prefer to add it later at this stage. So we'll just get that back up bubbling. I haven't been very well, cricked my neck a bit. I've got a problem with my neck and it's affects my whole body, so I was going to make this yesterday, but I have been struggling with it, so I just done the meat and then went to bed, so I'm a little bit better today, but not on top form. And my arthritis in my hands is playing up a lot as well, so that's not helping. So we'll just get this back up to a bubble. Cream ready. So this is, you know, quite close to how they would cook it in the Indian takeaways restaurants. Just gonna add 2 chef spoons of single cream now. Just turn the heat down a little bit on that now so that it doesn't split the cream. Through. Just make sure it's down on a low heat now, medium heat. Just keep it cooking. Put that meat in the middle there. Make sure it's cooked through. Should be fine because it was pre-cooked. Keep keep an eye on it so it don't burn out. Oh, beautiful. Really beautiful. It's supposed to have quite a red colour to it, but it's not that red, actually. So, some people might not like this, but I'm literally just going to pour a little bit of red food colouring on it. Don't need much, a little goes a long way. A little bit redder. Could add more, but it doesn't really matter. It's all about making it look nice for some people, and for me it's mainly more about the taste. Does get a little bit dry. Just add a little water. And once that's heated through, it should be good to go. Give it a little close up quickly. And that is it, my friends. So we'll turn the heat off that. And get it ready to heat up. This is quite a dry finish to it now, which is fine. Meat. This feeds two people this meal, but I haven't eaten for ages, so garnish it off now with a little bit of fenugreek leaves. Let's see. And there we have it, guys. Chicken tikka masala. Using yeast at home ingredients wherever possible. Have a good day, guys. All the best.